Hello students, welcome to the online class of biology for class 10th. Students, in your textbook of Selina, class 10th, in unit 1, chapter 2 is structure of chromosome, cell cycle and cell division. Chapter 1 is cell structure and its functions. That is for revision. You go through it because it is only for revision, and very rarely the questions are, and I already explained you that chapter in 9th class. Now under this chapter, structure of chromosome, cell cycle and cell division, there is a scope of syllabus, means the topics from which the questions are asked in your examination, that is cell cycle and mitotic phase. As you all know that cell divides, this you already learned in your previous classes. Yes, I already told you that cell divides, and there are the two, the cell divides in two ways. One is mitosis and meiosis. So when the cell divides, it all what all things are taking place in the nucleus. In the nucleus, that chromosomes are present, and that chromosomes divide and they are passed from one generation to another generation, means from parents to offsprings. That's why you know that your some of the characteristics are resembles to your parents. How it is possible? Yes, it is possible because of only chromosomes, because chromosomes are responsible for carrying the heredity characters from parents to the offsprings. Now let us see how these chromosomes are responsible to carry these hereditary characters from one generation to another generation. What all things are present in it? So you see, as I already written here, the chromosome, where they are present, they are present in the nucleus of the cell. Chromosome contain long DNA molecule. DNA molecule and protein together, these two things form chromatin. Chromatin, what are that? We will discuss afterward. Chromosome discovered in animals by Walter Fleming. It is the name of a scientist. And the animal in which it is discovered, animal name is salamander, and its larva contain the chromosome. That was discovered by Walter Fleming. Now, as I told you that we will learn chromatin afterwards. So here, what do you understand by chromatin? See, when we see without stain any cell under the microscope, we will unable to see anything. But if we dye that with any dye, then we see the colored structure, fiber form, in the form of a ball. Small ball-like structures are present in the nucleus in this form. They all are chromatin fibers. These chromatin fiber, from what they are made up of, this is the important thing which is asked in exam. Yes, from what it is made up of? It is made up of two substances, DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. Now, what percent it is present in the nucleus? It is present in the 40%. Second substance is histone. Now what are the histones? Histones are particular type of proteins, and its amount is 60%. So all together, these two things, what? Yes, DNA and histones, they together form chromatin fibers. So you remember, this is the question, that write the substances from which the chromatin material formed. Your answer will be good, DNA and histone. Now there is another thing which is present in the chromosome at the different locations, which are responsible for the characters which resembles to your parents. Have you ever thought of it, that how you are having these characteristics which are resembles to your parents? You are not an exact copy, but certain characteristics resembles to your parents, in your family member, like sometimes to your grandmother, grandfather, some resemblance is there. So how it takes place? It all because of genes are present in the chromosome. At different locations, these genes are located on chromosome. So these genes, they contain DNA, genetic material. They carry the heredity material from one generation to another generation, from parent to the offspring. In previous classes, you had learned this word genes. And at that time, I told you that this is the unit of heredity in simple thing. But here, the definition of genes is little more advanced. It is, genes are specific sequences of nucleotides on chromosome that encoded particular protein which expresses in the form of some particular feature of the body. They are the units of heredity which are transferred from parents to the offspring. And how they are transferring? Through the chromosomes, because on the chromosome these genes are located at different locations. They are responsible for some specific characteristics of offsprings. Yes, these genes are responsible for carrying the different hereditary characters from one generation to another generation. So, for this part, what you must remember? You remember the definition of gene. The definition of gene is asked in both the ways, in direct form, define the gene, or it can be asked, name the structure which is responsible for carrying, or what is the unit of heredity? Your answer will be gene. Now here you see the structure of chromosome. What it is? What is the structure? It is an important part of the chapter, because questions are asked on this topic. We can define it, chromosome, also in this way. The chromosome in condensed form during the cell division consists of two sister chromatids. So we can say chromosomes are the condensed form of chromatin fibers, which I told you in previous slide, that chromatin fibers, they are in the fiber form. When they condense, then they take the shape of this chromosome. So here, this chromosome, this is the single chromosome which contain chromatid and centromere. As you see, this chromosome is a duplicated chromosome here. Because why it is a duplicated chromosome? Because it contains two same chromatids that are also called sister chromatids, and these chromatids, they are joined with the point centromere. Now, how the questions are asked in the exam? In the exam, the questions are asked like this. Define chromatid. Chromatids are the arms of chromosome. Or what, in one word, if it is asked, it is asked like this. Arms of the chromosome, chromatid. Name the point where arms of or chromatid of chromosomes join together. The point is centromere. Or define centromere. Centromere can be defined as, it is a point where two chromatids are joined. So, my dear students, today what we had learned, today we had learned that in cell division, when the nucleus divide, it contains chromosomes. How the chromosomes, because of division in the chromosomes, and they are passed to the next generations, that hereditary characters pass from one generation to another generation. So chromosomes, what it is made up of, what is chromatin material, what are genes, and what is the structure of chromosome. So again, I am repeating that what you learn for your exam, from which the questions are asked, the structure of chromosome, what are chromatid, what is centromere,